Hey guys, it's your boy Gameson, and today we have a very special video, and to celebrate No Way Home today coming out, I thought I'd do a matchup versus Tobey Maguire Spider-Man, Andrew Garfield, Tom Holland, and Yuri Lowenthal Spider-Man from Spider-Man PS4. Today we're just going to be breaking down who is the superior Spider-Man. Basically, we're just going to be trying to do it from different angles to see who has the better powers, better suits, better swinging abilities. So yeah, let's get straight into this video. So how we're going to break this video up, and the main focuses are going to be strength, web shooting, power, agility, and suits. That'll pretty much the mainly the main categories we're going to be focusing on today. So without further ado, let's get into it. As strength goes for Tom Holland Spider-Man, he was actually able to hold together a full fairy with just his webbing and mostly just using his arms to actually hold it together a little bit without having to almost get help with from Iron Man later on. But it did show at that little portion of the movie that how far his strength does come and how much he can actually use that to his ability to actually save some people. This also means the fact that his webbing is definitely really strong compared to maybe Tobey and Andrew's, as well as Yuri Lowenthal's webbing, but we'll also get into that once we get around to the web swinging and etc. But yeah, I think this is much more impressive than saving a train than in Tobey's case, because he was actually able to use more of his arms and keep around a boat that was 3,000 tons. As strength goes for Tobey, obviously he has had the ability to stop at moving train going over at 200 miles per hour, but as I said with Tom, I feel like Tom's is much more impressive compared to what Tobey was able to do. And the reason why I wanted like pretty much think that is because he pretty much did stop more of a ferry, and a train really isn't only comes in at around 2,000 like tons. So in my opinion, Tom Holland is definitely stronger than Tobey's, but yeah, I mean, to be honest, it's not about how his web shoot and how his webs break, it's more about the strength he managed to put into it to save that. And obviously everyone argues that Tobey Maguire is the definitive version of strength, but in my opinion, Tom does do a way more to support this strength that he has. And that is being more stronger than Tobey, in my opinion. But this is very close between Tobey and Tom. As far as strength goes for Andrew Spider-Man, he's been capable of defeating the likes such as the Lizard, which is a very powerful Spider-Man villain, in my opinion, compared to a lot of the other villains, obviously. But yeah, he has been able to web him up very spider-like, and that also gets into the parts with his webs and how tensile strength to his webs make him even more stronger than his Spider-Man actually is. As well as that, in his second outing of Spider-Man, he was actually able to sort of play off the Green Goblin as he was trying to save Gwen in the Clock Tower in The Amazing Spider-Man 2, which pretty much he was able to use his webs, his feet, and also trying to hopefully grip on to try and save Gwen before they cut the webbing in half with the cogwheels. As I mentioned in The Amazing Spider-Man, he was able to web up Lizard with just all of his webs and basically brute strength just to try and disarm the Lizard. It actually lasted about 10 seconds before saving Gwen, but also he was also able to use in The Amazing Spider-Man 2 to use a manhole cover, which usually weighs around 113 kg, which is kind of heavy, but he was also able to use his webs in order to also take a blow to the Rhino. As far as strength goes for Yuri Lowenthal Spider-Man in Spider-Man PS4 game, he was actually able to save hundreds of lives from a falling crane that Mr. Negative and his henchmen had actually disarmed from a building, which a fully loaded crane usually weighs around 80,000, and when it's empty usually weighs around 35,000, which is mental.
But he was actually, Spider-Man was also able to catch this, which is very impressive. It shows his brute strength and able to use also his webbing, but also how he was able to web it to buildings as well. Which probably makes this Spider-Man the most superior as far as strength goes, even though this video game Spider-Man is actually a lot better than Tom Holland's Spider-Man when you're actually comparing these to the three movie variants of the character. So as the category of strength goes, I personally think that Advanced Suit Spider-Man takes this, mainly because he was able to stop a crane, which is much heavier than a train or a ferry. He is very, very superior when it comes to the strength part. But movie-wise, I would say that Tom does take it, but I feel that video game Spider-Man is definitely a lot stronger compared to these three. So moving on to web shooting, Tom's main web shooting abilities are very, very sleek in the way he does it, by, for example, taking down Falcon and Winter Soldier when he took them down in Civil War. He was very, very, very skilled in swinging around, taking them all out. And the way he actually shoots his webs as well shows how strong his webs actually are from holding them down so close to the ground. Tom's webbing definitely seems to hold for a very, very long time, as we've seen in Homecoming when he shot the web at Aaron Davis when he was interrogating him. It did hold on for quite a while.
Can I give you some advice?
Hmm?
You gotta get better at this part of the job.
I don't understand. I'm intimidating.
Staten Island Ferry, 11.
Oh, that's soon. Hey, that's gonna dissolve in 2 hours.
No.
So we know that Tom Holland's main web shooting ability can dissolve up to 2 hours, which is a very long time for any criminal being stuck in web. For Toby's web shooting ability, he mainly is organic fully, as he was pretty much bit by the spider and didn't have to make his own web shooters, which is a big ups to Mr. Tobey Maguire, because that means that he doesn't have to run out. He is just built full of web fluid, which is kind of disgusting, but he's going to be unlimited full of web fluid, so I think that he is definitely on the routes to winning this round. For Andrew's web shooting ability, he's obviously been able to make his web shooters himself, and also I think he is a much more skillful and more acrobatic swinger compared to the other two we've just mentioned. And the reason is because he is more of the more agile Spider-Man. He is more skinnier than most of them, which means he can do a lot more stunts. Same with Electro, he was also able to dodge multiple lightning attacks from Electro. And the amount of electricity and speed it uses is around 270,000 to shoot an entire bolt of electricity, which is mad. That means that his web shooters are probably a lot faster than that, so he can actually dodge that. So probably going over the 300,000 mark maybe, compared to how fast his web shooters can shoot. For Spider-Man on the PS4, it's kind of down to personal preference really, if you've ever played Spider-Man on the PS4. So it's basically just a really good web shooting experience, but the main character's main good parts of swinging is mostly because he is a much faster swinger than most of the other ones. So as far as this round goes, I'm going to hand it to Sam Raimi's Spider-Man, mainly because obviously his webs are more organic and I fear he could definitely do more damage without actually swinging and running out of webs. And the fact is that he could actually last longer in a battle while having organic webs as well, which he has shown throughout the movies, he never really runs out. So yeah, that is going to be Sam Raimi Spider-Man takes this round. So moving on to agility and powers, Tom Holland's main powers are from his tech, from his Stark suit, which he can do multiple different web attacks, also allowing him being agile. He should be able to jump over a helicopter into the Washington Monument to save Liz from Homecoming. Peter also has his AI companion named Karen, or just Suit Lady, which he allows him a bit of advantage over an opponent or anyone else for that matter. A really positive power to his Stark suit is the ability of his spider drone, in which he can surveil an area in which he can obviously intercept without being detected in any way. Toby's main power is obviously
really good really good at wall crawling, which she has emphasised the first Spider-Man movie. His agility is really just mainly jumping higher than most of the other Spider-Men. But obviously considering when these movies were released, which was technology was very different, he wouldn't have had any superpowers allowing him to do any other extra stuff. This doesn't really put him as much of a disadvantage, as he is able to squeeze through tight gaps and also quickly do really quick manoeuvres, as we've seen in the train fight in Spider-Man 2. In Andrew's case, agility is definitely what Andrew Garfield stands for, considering he is able to do multiple backflips when dodging attacks and also being able to save a kid off a bridge from a burning car. His spider powers aren't exactly perfect, but of course he definitely has a very efficient technique of wrapping up his enemies and going behind them and also taking them out that way by using his webs, and also, as I said, doing multiple stunts to kind of finesse his opponent basically. Andrew's main agility really comes in when he's mainly swinging around, as he is able to kind of go over the fire escapes, like go around the buildings really easily, something that a lot of other Spider-Men really can't do, to be honest with you. In the PS4 game, Yuri Lowenthal's Spider-Man is actually very, very agile. I think he could definitely be up there as one of the most agile Spider-Men out there next to Andrew's. Obviously dodging really last minute attacks from SWAT teams and obviously from Kingpin henchmen, as well as the other bosses you fight in that game. Another thing that also makes this Spider-Man very agile is the fact he can actually slide through people's legs and also break down their shields, which is a pretty good technique to actually disarm any enemies, and also he's also able to web guns and throw them back at them. And obviously using his super move, he can basically just whiplash anyone that comes in his way. Alright, so for guys, for agility powers, I'm definitely going to have to give this round to Andrew Garfield. Preferably because I think we all knew it was coming. He definitely is the most agile and more powerful Spider-Man, and definitely has a very high IQ on how to get around difficult situations. So yeah, to agility and powers goes to Andrew Garfield. None for Tom Holland yet, but we will see once we get into the suits. As far as Tom Holland's suits go, he obviously has his Stark suit from Homecoming, as well as that he has the Iron Spider from Infinity War, upgraded suit from Far From Home, integrated suit and black and gold suit, both from No Way Home, which I haven't seen yet, which I'll be seeing on Sunday. But I believe the black and gold suit actually has some powers to that. There was also the stealth suit from Far From Home, which he used to take down the elemental creatures, which doesn't really support many abilities as such. It just kind of just hides his identity when he was in Prague. As far as suits go for Toby, he mainly just used his black suit, obviously his normal costume getting a few changes with the spider logo and such. But the black suit really changed his character in Spider-Man 3, of course, just knowing how having a different personality can change your whole appearance, basically. And to be honest, obviously the power that comes with the symbiote and all the crazy abilities you can have, like being twice stronger, is insane. Throughout his two solo films, Andrew Garfield only wore two suits, one in The Amazing Spider-Man and then the second in The Amazing Spider-Man 2, which, to be honest, didn't give him much of an upgrade to compared, but the suit definitely looked a lot more comic accurate and is still remains to this day one of the most comic accurate suits of Spider-Man to this day on live action. There are multiple suits to choose in the Spider-Man 2018 video game, but there has been multiple suits added, both from the comics and movies and just Insomniac spin-off suits as well. There are basically their own original things, such as the Advanced suit, as you can see here. But nothing too much to elaborate on, considering there's just a lot of suits. So obviously guys, in conclusion after that, the suits category definitely puts Tom in the lead, mainly because of his multiple choices of suits throughout the movies he's done, as well as all of the other things that he's managed to use throughout the suits, being able to build his own suits as well and not having to rely on just a bunch of
paperwork and just ideas to make his own suit, but he was actually just gifted it to him by Tony Stark, which I feel is much better considering he is a kid. Like, how can a kid make like a multi-billion dollar looking suit looking like this? But yeah, to be honest with you, it's pretty cool because it felt more realistic as Tom did it. So Tom takes the suits round. Alright, so each Spider-Man has 1 point right now. So I'm thinking this is going to end in a draw. So what I'm thinking you is you guys can comment down below who you think is the best Spider-Man out of these four. And leave your suggestions down below. And I'll actually tell you my favourite. My personal favourite is Yuri Lowenthal, considering he is everything what Spider-Man was to be. Everything in that video game just summed up Spider-Man perfectly. Whereas I think the best live action, I know I'm going to get slaughtered a lot for this, is preferably Tom, considering he is, obviously he is the new Spider-Man. They did change a lot of things about like the older versions of Spider-Man from Tobey's and Andrew's and stuff. But I believe that Tom is the best live action Spider-Man interpretation, and Yuri Lowenthal is the best video game adaptation of Spider-Man. So I'd like to thank you guys very much for watching. I'm off to bed now because this took an insane amount of time.
Anyway guys, subscribe if you're new. And I've been Game Scene. Peace.